A what? Sorry. What are you saying? I'm on. I'm on. What am I on? I'm on what? I'm on.
I'm on.
Yeah, I'm always on. Always on. I'm on. I'm on camera. I'm on camera. I'm on. Oh! Oh shit! Oh shit! Whoops-a-daisy. Hey folks, Kilt-Man here. Kilt-Man! At your service.
I'm so sorry if I didn't hear you on the phone.
The staunch clap has scared the clientele. But, anyway, bravo to you all, bravo. This is actually a Freedom Friday. Yes, a Freedom Friday. Many Facebook followers and regular YouTube subscribers will know that Freedom Friday is a major night of all day of free for all and crazy chaotic and bedlam. And it has been, it definitely has been. And then it came to a crashing fucking whoosh, a big like one of them, you know, a big belly flop. You know, you go up there, or you're gonna chance it on the big high dive. Yeah, the birds are watching you. The ladies are all there. You know, 14, 15, you think your hormones are supercharged. You think you can fly. And you go off the high board, and you just, ooh, and then your belly just goes, whoop, boosh, ooh. Thunderclap, tsunami, every which way. And that's kind of been, that illustrates my day today. Now, yesterday was the hottest day on air ever, apparently. On air. Or well, certainly for the UK. The hottest day on record. And it was unbelievably hot. We had thunderstorms and rain and fucking all sorts. But it did not affect the heat. The heat only went up and up and up and up and up. Because yours truly was out and about, you know, and Facebook followers, you've seen pictures of me. I was there, I was out in it, and having a right old time with it too. But my hair remained lovely and luxurious, and it was down here. And then today, which is like, literally 10 degrees cooler, and my hair has gone like to this fucking, so it's like, oh, it just hovers around his chin. It's a little chinny piece, you know. Although, you know, we have, can you see that? Can you see that? I have my hawk Lakota Sioux Indian feathers in there, and the medicine wheel as well. And yeah, it didn't protect my hair from going like in the ultra humidity which we are now suffering from. So anyway, today has been a weird day. I was off work the last two afternoons, and I went out and just partied, you know. And today, I fucking wish I had got off in the afternoon. I'm partied, because no, I went out at dinner time. I did as is normal. Had a laugh, had a joke, and like thrust my flesh to the sun. You know, the sun, it was very cloudy, but the sun was coming through. And then went back to work and save the nation all over again. And it was a Freedom Friday. Every Friday for me is a Freedom Friday, and but because I've been out the last two nights, afternoons and nights, Mrs. Kilman was like, don't you fucking dare go out again. And I won't, I promise you, I swear to God. And if you do, you stay in touch on your phone, don't ignore my text messages, don't even know my phone calls. But anyway, I come out of work late, 7 o'clock, 7 a fucking clock. That's in the PM. 7 o'clock in the PM, and I was fucking knackered, you know. So I thought, well, I don't really fancy a big all-nighter round town, which is what I do normally, and I just didn't fancy it. Oops-a-daisy, like, you know, Kilt-Man, dropping the ball there. Where is your party spirit? Come on, you're a fucking wild thing, an animal. Yeah, I am normally, and anyway, so I went to the Hole in the Wall, ye olde Hole in the Wall in town, which is the oldest pub in Liverpool, historical pub in Liverpool, and I had a fair few whiskages. It was great, and it's full of tourists too, so I was kind of like fucking henpecked and like, oh, hey, you've got a kilt on, why are you wearing a kilt? Hey, you know, which part of the Highlands are you from? And all this kind of shit, like, isn't it? And then you got the Japanese going like, "Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Where are you?" And I'm going like, whatever. And then of course these fucking feathers confuse everybody. And of course, the U.S. cavalry belt. There you go. Which really does confuse people to hell and back, especially Americans. You know, Americans come over and like. No offense to, you know, you Yanks, but you've got no fucking idea what the, about the whole, the mashup, you know. And like, there's no reason why I can't wear a US cavalry belt, because I admired, you know, the tactics and the strategy and the warfare and the uniforms of US cavalry. But I hated the doctrine which was governing them, you know, about genocide. So my heart lies with the American Indian, the Native American. So, which is why I'll wear feathers in my hair, but I do love, you know, the soldier blue. That poor guy who went out there, he went his politics, he went out there, did his job. And fuck me, but has not the MX Marines as well. So I know damn well, you know, what any government, any monarchy, any ruling authority can make its armed forces do in their name. And of course, once you sign up, you've pledged your life and your duty to whatever their fucking bullshit rules are going to be, whatever their strategy is going to be. You've got to be there for queen and country, king and country, the sovereign, you know, for whatever. So, yeah. So I sit on the fence with this one. I despise, you know, what America, what the new Americans did to the Native Americans. Despise with a vengeance. Which is why I'll always, always, you know, endorse, you know, tribal. Like I have lots and lots of like Arapaho, Cherokee, and especially Lakota Sioux bling. Jewelry, beads, and the entire thing. You know, I love it beyond belief. But so wherever I was going with this preamble, it's gone off somewhere else. Who knows? But town was jumping, town was crazy, and I really didn't want to come home. But I did. I made that sacrifice. I got on the train, the Iron Horse, and I made that journey back. And I knew where I wanted to come when I got the train, and to be met pretty much within 30 seconds of going to the train, and me running up the hill, running like fucking Trojan fucking warrior. And there was the wife and the dog waiting for me top of the hill. I was like, do I turn around and run back down again? Do I try and hide behind a car? In fact, I did hide behind a car. I did try and, like, you know, trick the dog. Roxy, the husky wonder dog. Didn't work. She went under the car and grabbed my ankle and fucking dragged me. You know, she could have come round to the side and gone, "Hello, Dad." But no, had to drag me under the fucking car. Bounce me off the curb and like, yeah. "Oh, it is you after all, it is you, Dad. Yeah, yeah. You smelt similar, but you weren't acting the same, so I'll just savage you to make sure you are who you're meant to be." In the meantime, guys, I'm hoping you're all having a good time. I know Sam even liked these little impromptu videos. Glenn! Glenn. My man. You are a superstar. You have stood by me for fucking, I don't know, decades. It seems like that anyway. 80 forum days, you were always there. You always loved the amount of shit that I wrote about movies. My waxing lyrical about films. And we are kindred spirits without a doubt. We love our 80s stuff. We love our, you know, macho movie heroics. We love our sci-fi, our horror. We love it. And we're not alone. There is not just us. There's many, many people. Many girls. You know, this is the thing that always surprises me. When you get talking, talking movies, you expect them to talk about the latest movies, rom-com bullshit. Now that's me making a very horrible stereotypical fucking viewpoint there. And then they go, oh, my favorite film is The Thing, or my favorite film is Texas Chainsaw Massacre, or The Shining. And you're like, shit. I love Hills of Eyes. I met a girl only the other day. She said, I love the Hills of Eyes. Sorry though. The original or the remake? And she went, I love both. I thought, right on, babe, right on. So that's the thing about movies can be so misogynistic. You know, obviously, you know, the whole stuff slash genre is built around. And it is. It's built around the vulnerable female. But always, you're always going to be more, you know, worried about the girl rather than the bloke. The bloke can fight back. So, in the mass movie-going audience, a female teenager is more vulnerable than anybody else. So, makes it more scary. That's why they fucking do it all the time. I've always loved films where the gung-ho jock gets fucking cleaved in half. His bravado gets beaten down. But I tell you what, I would love one day, if I was gonna make a stuff-ass movie, I would love to have like a big jock knobhead dude who just like, well, fuck you. You know, you're just a guy with a machete. I've done a bit of martial arts. I can take you down. And does and beats the shit out of Syria. That'd be like a real, like, what the fucking hell, you know? Oh, but will he come back from the grave? You know, he got his head stoved in. You know, the guy comes at you, a lumbering brute. He might be like fucking 8 feet tall, but he's always slow and methodic. He's got a mask on, so he can't fucking see. He's got no peripheral vision whatsoever. You know, he's breathing his own spit back in again. So he's not in a good way. Not in a good way. He's wearing a mask and not to, allay his own identity. It's because he's an ugly, deformed fucker. That is how the normal serial killer movie, you know, monster works. He wears a mask to conceal the evil monstrosity that lurks beneath the latex. And so, you know, your hero jock, your hero woman, it doesn't have to be the last girl alive. We've just had a year of women's sports, really, you know, the Football World Cup, the women's sports there, you know, the netball, oh my God. Women fucking kick ass. They kick ass superbly. They don't roll around on the floor like, oh my God, my knee, They don't like, you know, have a fake hit and then go, a minute after they go, oh! And they fall over. These girls play the game, get up again and play on, play, play on. Watching the Women's World Cup football was just an absolute dream. It was, they were fit beyond belief, all of them. But, yes, there you go, sexist, misogynist, kilt man. But hey, it's That's what happens. And but their skills were unbelievable. Their speed, their agility, their tactics. God, it was ironed out. These girls knew. They were almost telepathic. And it was so great to watch. So great to watch. So, this is the thing about like the horror movie and the last girl alive, the final girl. She's always the one. She's almost always the virgin. You know, because the whole thing is like, you know, teenagers who fuck will get killed. It's immoral. That's the American sort of subversive slant on these things. Really? Is it? Really? Is it that political? It just sex sells. So you have people who are fucking, you know, illicitly and they're babysitting. They should be babysitting, but they're fucking on the couch. And like, so you're being punished for like neglecting a child there, for neglecting your duties, just being, you know, having sex. And you know, is that really, you know, a death sentence? It's all very strange, all very strange. But, you know, the American Hollywood genre history is literally strewn with this, even predating Psycho. Hitchcock's Psycho adaptation of Robert Bloch's awesome novel, where you kill off, you know, the woman you've been following for a good half hour, and you believe that she's the heroine, and she gets killed off. Awesomely clever. It's been oft, you know, riffed on in many other movies, of course, but and of course Jamie Lee Curtis, who plays Laurie Strode in the Halloween franchise, is the daughter of Janet Leigh, who was Marion Crane, who was killed in Psycho. So it's just tremendous, the legacy of all these horror movies, and like the way that women have played up in these. Women are, and you know, this is no offence to all the fair folk out there. Women will always, and you can't get around it, will be the fragile and vulnerable out of society. So movies will always reflect upon that. Women will be the ones who are stalked, hunted, slashed, and out. As a cinema-going audience, as a male, you know, you feel disempowered because you can't stop that. Your instinct is to stop a woman being hurt. So, to watch it in movies, this is where it works both ways. Women, you know, obviously associate with the victim. And they're going like, oh, the fucking hell, why'd you go? Well, why did you take your clothes off and then walk into the dark room there? Well, yeah, of course, there is exploitation going on there. And I think a lot of films these days don't really do that. They show women to be a bit more forthright, a bit more like, you know, in charge of what they're up to. It isn't just a spoon-fed fucking, like, victim, you know, on a leash. I'll just drag you through here, take your clothes off, show your titties, and like, then you're going to get nagged to bits. You know, I don't think that really happens so much now. But blokes have a reaction to that sort of thing as well. That's why these films work. Women should, in the old days, the drive-in, you know, Friday the 13th and Halloween, that whole stalker slash genre, women were the victims, and like women would shudder and, you know, crawl into their boyfriend, their husband, or whatever. And the guy would feel empowered because, oh, well, you know, I'll look after you, don't worry, I'll take care of you. I have my lightsaber down here. I have an Uzi 9mm phase plasma rifle with a 40 watt range. They feel like they're the jock, they do the defense. But time and time again in movies of this genre, the jock would be off pretty quickly. He'd try and defend this girl, but he'd be skewered, pitchfork go through him, his eyes would be gouged out, heads off, like, and then the killer turns around on the poor girl, who is just like, one of those, you know, ear piercing, tinnitus creating fucking screams. And, you know, it's a format, it's a formula. It's also a winning formula, but it does wear, it does wear. It's a galvanistic sort of thing. You feel, you are definitely, horror movies work on a very primal level. They get you in there. Your instinct, your DNA kicks in and fires you up, fight or flight. Most guys you think want to protect and fight with a woman. In the harsh streets of reality, and I've seen it too many times, the guy turns tail and runs. Now, what I'm saying, what I'm trying to preach here, I shouldn't preach anything, I'm not qualified to preach anything, but I lived my life in like wildness and craziness and all different forms of employment, but I've lived partying on the streets of many cities. I've seen all manner of crap taking place. And women not only are the victims, but they are also the instigators. And the worst violence I've ever seen has been perpetrated by women. Women know how to gouge eyes out. They know how to use their nails. They know how to go for the groin. They know how to. And this isn't just like fighting men. It's fighting other women. I've seen the most, usually in chippies, you know, chip shops. Christ, white girl is there. The heels come off, stilettos, and they're going for the eyes. Fuck me. Do special forces train that? Well, they didn't train me to go for the eyes like that. But, you know, Christ almighty. These are some volatile bitches. Now, if that's the way it's meant to be, that's the way instinct kicks in for them. Brilliant. Brilliant. It's a fucking winning move, obviously. But guys try to intervene and they get the shit kicked out of them. Yeah. I saw a guy wearing glasses. His glasses were smashed in with a high heel and then mashed into his face. He was trying to break up a fight. So yeah, madness, much madness. Yeah, I've had tons of whiskey, and hey, so what? It's a Freedom Friday, and I'm looking incredibly fat of face. My hair is a fucking big, mad, cave fucking mess. What we have, the dartboard from the slaughtered lamb. You, me, miss. I've never missed that ball before. The best one's ever made. Love it. Hey. I've covered some weird shit. I've gone off on weird, wacky tangents. I have started things and not finished them off. I have raised stuff. I've raised societal, you know, queries and questions and why we do what we do. And I've offered no answers. But it gets you thinking, doesn't it? It gets you thinking, like, why the hell has this guy still got a YouTube channel? What the hell is this guy doing? Why can't this fucking dickhead go back home and open a package and show me a mask or a sword or whatever? Yes. There's plenty. I know. There's loads there. You're gonna get it. But you know me. You all know me. I like to, like, just keep you abreast of what the hell I'm doing and where I am. And where I am right now is bullshit. This guy should have stayed out in town. Town was bouncing, town was great. I was getting the attention the Kilt-Man fucking deserves. But no, because I've been out the last three nights on the trot. I kind of felt guilty. I thought, no, come home, come home, come home. I promised I'd come home. But therein lies, you know, I'm hamstrung now. Although I've got that. And that. Now that, all coupled together, that's quite a lot of whiskey. So, in a way, you can see why I've done this video right now, because when I leave here and I stagger and crawl and roll back home. Oh, there's that mask. I'll just go and do a big video on this. Now you know why. Because I was like, I just fall asleep. Like that. Guys, your Fridays, are they Freedom Fridays? Are they, okay, mine was a disaster today, but are they, what do you do? Is your weekend, are you weekends? Do you live for your weekends? Do you go out and party every Friday, Saturday, Sunday? What do? Do you go out? Do you go like Caribbean? Do you go, you know, the Balearics? Do you go Ibiza? What do? How do you guys party? You know, I'm 50 now, but I still fucking party. So I want to know what you guys do. Come on, you're all out there. And also, while I'm on this topic, for fuck's sake, we're almost approaching 300 subscribers. Now, that is phenomenal. For me, for a little jumped up nomad in a vest and a kilt, with ridiculous hair and chubby cheeks, talking bullshit and drinking whiskey all the time. Now, that's quite a phenomenal feat. I'm not on Love Island. Yes. I'm nowhere. It's just me doing this and you guys watching it. But it would be great to go further, because the further we get, the more subscribers we get, the better the show could become. And we all want that. We all want better than this shit, don't we? This shit is fucking dire. Just me sitting here going, oh, blah, 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 blah. And then going like... Blah, 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 blah. So, guys, please, let's get the subscription numbers up. I can only do what I can do. I can only publicize it as much as I can publicize it. I just do what I do. It's got to be liked and shared and then fucking thrust out there. And go, hey, look at this guy. This guy's a complete tosser. He's an absolute knobhead. But, you know, but he knows it. But he knows it. And occasionally, he might give a nugget of something interesting. He's gone to space and he come back and they think he's dead. The piped music. The waffle in the background. Do you know, I met the wife, Mrs. Kilt-Man, with the dog. And we come back, we took a long route back. And I said, do you want to come with a drink? And I meant to come with a drink in here, in Telegraph. And knowing full well that on Fridays, she's dead. It's fucking dead. It's always dead on Friday. It never used to be, but it bloody well is now. But no, so we walked past that. He said, oh, no. So went to the cask around the corner. I went there. Fucking bands playing, giving it loads. And it was busy, it was chocking, it was great. But I thought, you know what, I'll do a video, but I can't fucking do it in there. But rather in there. So I thought, I'll come back around here. And then come back around there. A little bit of inspiration and, you know, a bit of fucking frivolity. Gotta be honest, this pub has long been known as being my favourite. But I've got to say, It's doing, done nothing for me for weeks now. Weeks, months in fact. It's a great looking boozer. Loads of little rooms and bits and bobs to it. Lovely beer garden. But atmosphere wise, there's fucking nothing here. Nothing at all. And it's a Friday night. It's a Friday fucking night. And no one's here. Except for me. I should have stayed in the cast. The band was great. There was a big rapport going on. Kilt-Man was like, aye, Kilt-Man. But no, I chose to leave on purpose to come here so I could do a video. And now I'm regretting, you know, the whole fucking thing about it. If any one of you has put up with this entire video, you deserve a fucking medal. Tomorrow you'll get more things of actual genuine substance. I just, hey, look, I'm not with the crowd, I'm not with any mates, there's no ladies here. Fucking hell, there was in town and there was in the pub before, but dickhead here chose to come out so I could do a video. And I shook his fucking, mind you, the band was too loud, so I couldn't do it in there. But anyway, guys, it's a great big pile of whatevers, you know, a big shovel full of who gives a fuck. It's just, you know, a deluge of so what, a tsunami of ow, whatevs. So in the meantime, you guys, keep it kilted, keep it Celtic. Play darts, drink whiskey, have fun, and misogyny and stereotyping in movies and stalker slash, fuck it, just what happens. So in the meantime, folks, the meantime and the in-between time, I'm gonna see you all, ooh, fucking well, fatted cow later. If I post this video, you'll know what a shit night this turned out to be.